Yes, people, welcome back to the channel. Today we have an unexpected video. I'll be honest, I absolutely did not know the Porcupine Tree were releasing new music. And I don't think, maybe a lot of people haven't if you don't keep up with their social medias, or I don't even know if they have social media. I believe Stephen Wilson might. But this is their first track in 12 years, which I've only actually just became aware of in the last few minutes. Basically, opened up YouTube, in the comment section of some of my videos, you guys said new Porcupine Tree. I was like, hold on a minute, when was the last time I've actually listened to a new release from Porcupine Tree? And then I was thinking to myself, hold on, I've never actually jumped on a new release because, like I said, there hasn't been one for 12 years. So this one is their first track in a long, long time. It's called Harridan, which I had to look up what the meaning of that word actually meant. And apparently it's a strict, bossy, or belligerent old woman. Choice words. In Ireland, we'd call them an absolute cheers. But anyway, lads, firstly, before we jump into this one, obviously I've been a big fan of Porcupine Tree for the last while, especially on YouTube. You know, they've been, you know, quite a popular band to cover on the channel. I've also done a lot of Stephen Wilson's solo work, so I mean, there is a lot of videos on the channel. If you are new to the channel, I encourage you to go and check them out, just so at least you guys are familiar with my history with Porcupine Tree. Also, big shout out to everyone who showed love on the last video. It done really, really well. People really got behind that. The album reactions is something I've kind of been considering. There's a few album reactions that I've gotten requested in the last video as well, so I'm probably going to spend some time this weekend checking them out as well. So guys, get ready, make sure you're subbed, make sure you drop a like on this video as well. I'm actually really interested to see what this is all about, man. I have got inside information. Someone's already listened to it that I know, and he said that I need to put the prog cap back on, right? Because obviously I've been listening to a lot of, you know, more intense metal, Meshuggah, to name a few. And this one requires me going back to, I suppose, my roots. I'd say my roots with metal. So prog cap is on, metaphorically and literally. So without any further ado, let's go. Oh yeah, it's been a while since I listened to Porcupine Tree. Let's also hope that this music video doesn't get blocked. Or a lyric video, I should say. Eerie. I'm already hearing is it still Gavin Harrison who plays drums, man? I'm kind of guessing at this point because, like I said, it's been quite a while since I listened to Porcupine Tree. Well, not that it's been quite a while, but the music that I've heard from them is 12 plus years old, so I actually don't know what their current actual lineup is. I know that's still Stephen Wilson, you know, Daddy Wilson. Remains intact. Is it still Gavin Harrison? Let me just double check. I believe it is still Gavin Harrison. It's quite simple, but it's groovy already, you know? Okay, right. I'm just gonna give my opinions just as I'm going, just freeballing it. Yeah, I could say that. I've been listening to quite a bit of Pink Floyd lately. I wasn't even gonna bother trying to do it on the channel because I can imagine they're a ball ache to try and get uploaded without any copper issues. Just trying to, you know, delve a little bit deeper into the roots of a lot of the metal that I listen to today. I know Pink Floyd aren't necessarily traditionally metal, but they do have metal elements and they have paved the way for a lot of the bands that I've listened to. I know Tool took quite a bit of influence from Pink Floyd and some of the other bands that are quite trippy, and they've just paved the way for a lot of music today. You know, that trippy element, the real kind of hypnotizing, euphoric, kind of almost eerie sound. I'm hearing Stephen Wilson's vocals kind of remind me of Pink Floyd. Maybe I'm reaching a little bit, but just because it's fresh in my mind. Yeah, look, I have been listening to The Dark Side of the Moon quite a lot, just to kind of familiarize myself with a lot of these, like I said, these older bands, you know, just so I can offer more from an opinion point of view. And their music has stood the test of time, you know, people still listen to them to this day. So I wanted to check them out for myself because I haven't really heard them before. And again, people will always say, well, how have you not heard Pink Floyd, you know? But I'm not even doing videos for them, you know? There's no reason for me to lie. It'd be one thing if I was doing like a reaction video and like hadn't heard them before, but I'm just listening to them my own time, just, you know, educate myself. And I'm hearing, you know, similar vocals from Stephen Wilson, just reminding me of that. Not necessarily that he's taken any influence, but it just reminds me personally. So let's keep going. Do you know what, actually, I'm going to try and avoid heavily pausing it. I'm just going to stop here, but that really reminded me of Maynard James Keenan from Tool, this part here. Really Tool-esque, that like almost like echoey concert hall sound to the vocals. Yeah, that sounded a lot like Tool. I love the acoustic element that is always so present in Porcupine Tree. Oh my god. And then, you know, this part's nice as well. Oh yeah, that's a statement. There it is. That's the sound we all know. This is eerie though. Yes. This video is pretty sick as well. Oh man. That's pretty sick. Yes. Oh man, it's bringing me back. This is a throwback to how I kind of first got into a lot of these bands, you know. It just spirals. It started with like, say, Slipknot, and then I'd obviously mentioned certain elements of Slipknot that I might have liked, and it just kind of slowly trickled down into like really fine-tuning bands that I liked. Then I got on to Tool. I believe the Fear Inoculum album came out, and then people were obviously hyping that up, so I got on Tool. And then I was like, all right, hold on, let me give Tool another chance, because I listened to Fear Inoculum, and then I listened to some of their older tracks, then they dropped Fear Inoculum. And then slowly, from there, started hearing like, oh, you'd probably like Porcupine Tree, listen to Anesthetize. And if you haven't seen that video, lads, if you are new to the channel, there's probably going to be a lot of new people that maybe have not seen the channel before, just based on the fact that Porcupine Tree obviously haven't released in 12 years. Go back and check that out. That was the first time I ever heard anything by Porcupine Tree. Made me a massive fan, and then kind of set off another spiral of checking out Stephen Wilson's solo work as well, of which I've still not done a lot of, but, you know, I've got quite a good grounding on, you know, who they are and who Stephen Wilson is in particular. But yeah, like, this is really just kind of winding back the last few years or last few months, whatever you want to call it, of just reasons why I really liked Porcupine Tree, because like before that drop just happened there, you know, a minute or two ago, I was just mentioning the acoustic elements that I really love. They're quite hypnotizing and, you know, mellow, but then you just get all of a sudden struck by this crazy metal elements as well that they have, and they're so good at it as well. But then they kind of go into this like almost like thrash, like it's like a thrash metal. It just sounds real, like it picks up the tempo, and then they'll slowly go back into the slower part and then go into the kind of, you know, those nicer guitarists as well. So yeah, it's a throwback. It's still got new elements of Porcupine Tree that I haven't really heard. Like I said, I never really heard them too much with those vocals, those kind of Maynard James Keenan-esque vocals at the start. But, you know, they've definitely kind of stay true to the band that they are. This part's sick. This feels like a VR experience. This is really good quality on this video. There's almost like a kind of like a electronic element to this part as well. That almost like flangered effect in the background, really EDM-esque. Feel like I'm in a techno nightclub. Porcupine Tree have quite a distinct snare as well. Gavin Harrison has a really distinct snare. I know it's a lot to do with the drum pattern and the kind of groove of it as well, but that snare just sounds very, very distinct. Just me? Let me know. Oh, they're teasing it. Oh, man, this is, imagine tripping out on this, tripping balls. Yeah, this is what this is designed for. And the video is playing into that a lot as well. Wow. Oh wow, yeah. Yeah, you really. This feels like a Steven Wilson solo track. All the goosebumps. All the goosebumps are so strong. I'll be honest, because I haven't really listened to them frequently, like over the last while, I didn't get the overall goosebumps of like the return, because to be honest, I actually didn't know it's been 12 years, but knowing that it was 12 years, I'm actually glad I found that out, because it wouldn't have meant as much not knowing this, but that last part there gave me chills, felt like a Steven Wilson solo track. But yeah, that was Porcupine Tree's brand new release. Let me just double check, have they got an album coming up? I would imagine this is the, you know, the first baby steps of releasing an album. First single, maybe potentially off an upcoming album. Okay, so news just in. Porcupine Tree return with new single, Harridan, and closure slash continuation album announcement. The cult experimental rock band will also head out on tour next year. Okay. All right. I wonder if we're going to get an Irish date. But yeah, lads, the prog videos, I always forget, go on a little bit longer than most videos on the channel have for the last while. In saying that, the last video was an hour long, so I've got a bit of wiggle room. But if you did enjoy the video, lads, it'd be much appreciated if you could drop a like. Obviously, let me know what you think of the new track. I personally did really enjoy it. I kind of forgot that Porcupine Tree had such a, like they do still have that metal, like really metal element as well, but it's almost like an electronic-y feel that they string through the track. It's not like your traditional, like I said, the way they described this in this article I'm reading here. How did they describe the band? Because it's pretty spot on. The cult experimental rock band. Yeah, nail on the head, to be honest. That's probably the best way you could actually go about describing the music that they have. You can't really pigeonhole them to one genre. Like, you hear the parts at the start reminded me a little bit like Tool. And then I can't even compare the breakdowns that they have in the middle of the track, because it is like almost an electronic-y sound to a degree, obviously mainly like that traditional metal sound, but it does have like an almost like a faster paced electronic beat that runs through it as well. And then at the end you get almost a Stephen Wilson track, you know, thrown in at the end. So again, lads, that was the first prog track I've done in quite some time, so you need to kind of readjust. Well, I need to kind of readjust, you know, the way in which I listen to it, because obviously Meshuggah is such instant feedback, you know, you just get pounded with riffs all the time, whereas Porcupine Tree and prog rock bands that I've done in the past requires a little bit more, I won't say attention, but you do have to tweak the way in which you listen to it a little bit more and appreciate the project as a whole, as opposed to just loving certain elements of the track that break down into crazy breakdowns. So yeah, lads, please drop a like in the video, it would be much appreciated. Make sure you're subbed to the channel. Let me know in the comment section down below if you want me to check out the album when it does drop, and if there's any other albums or tracks that I need to check out, guys. As always, thank you so much for watching the video. I'm signing out. Take care of yourselves. Cheers.